Hallelujah! Easter blessings to everyone. Christ has risen. This is Miss Megan, and we're going to be doing our children's church lesson this morning on this beautiful Easter morning. But I'm going to be doing it a little bit different than the format you've gotten used to the last few weeks. So join me as I'm going to retell the Easter story for you. So come with me on that adventure. We're here today celebrating Easter. There was once a man who loved big enough to change the world. They could tell that he was with God and God was with him. Everywhere he went, people would ask this man whose name was Jesus, "What's the best way to live?" And Jesus would say, "Love, love God, love yourself, love everyone else." Now, there were some people who did not like what Jesus was teaching. They did not want to be told to love God, love themselves, or love everyone else, because that's a very hard thing to do. So instead of learning this hard, hard thing, they decided to have Jesus killed. And this was the hard part of the story. But when we tell this part of the story, we always say, this is not the ending of the story. Because God's story always has a good ending. The hard part of the story is that Jesus' enemies did a bad thing, and they had him killed on a cross. Jesus' friends, the ones who knew that God was in him and that he was in God, were very sad, and their hearts were broken. They put Jesus in a tomb, which was like a cave, and they used a big stone for a door. And then, I imagine they took some time to cry, to hug each other, and to try to fix their hearts. After Jesus died, some of his friends who loved and missed him went to the tomb where he was buried. The tomb was like a cave with a huge, huge rock close to it to shut it off. But when they got there, they discovered that the huge, huge rock that had been blocking the door was moved. When they went inside, they saw an angel sitting on top of a rock who said to them, "Do not be afraid. You're sad about Jesus, but this is good news. He is alive again." Now, this is a mysterious story. This is the story that changes the cross from a sad thing to a good thing. It reminds us that no matter what happens, no matter how times get hard or people hurt us, God is always with us. This makes us brave enough to love God and love ourselves and love each other. I'm going to end our story today with a blessing. And so everyone knows God is always with them. God, thank you for always being with us. Help us to love you, love ourselves, and love everyone else. Amen.